Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Chellen. Well, we have an impossibly hard question today sent in by Pat. Pat says, I need to match addresses up. You know, our customer database is just a mess. We have addresses that are entered one way and not the other way. And, you know, I hear this, but this particular one was the worst that I've seen. Because the example, there's four address lines. And she said, hey, these are a match. 123 Mayfair Garden on New Street and number 123 New Street on Mayfair Garden. She wants those to match. They're not even in the same column. Oh, wow. So I came over here, first of all, I said, okay, let's get all of these into a single column. So I entered a formula of A2 ampersand B2 ampersand C2 ampersand D2. So that way, at least I have one single bit of text. And this solution goes back to a challenge of the month from long, long ago called the FuzzyMatch problem. And Juan Pablo sent in a great user-defined function that was modified and modified. And at this point, it's come a long way. If you just go to Google and search for Fuzzy, and then site colon MrExcel.com, you'll get to all of these discussions. This one here, Alan's UDFs for the FuzzyMatch problem from I'll Be Seeing You, has what I think is the definitive FuzzyMatch logic. Click that link, and basically you're going to take this code that Al wrote out here, and it gives you three new functions. So we would copy all this code right from the message board, and we want to paste that into Excel, of course. So Control C to copy, come back to Excel. Normally what you do is Alt F11, and then Insert Module, and then Control V to paste. I've already pasted it in here. It gives us three new functions, one called Fuzzy VLOOKUP, and that's the one that I'm going to start with. Fuzzy VLOOKUP over here in column F, basically Fuzzy VLOOKUP, I said, hey, take this value that's in E2 and go look through the rest of the addresses from E3 down to E10. I was careful there to put a dollar sign, so that way it always stops at E10. And when you find it, tell me the column number one. And what it does is it finds a match all the time, even if there's just a couple of letters in common. So then you have to come over to column G and use another one of Al's functions, fuzzy percent. That says, hey, now that we have this match, E3 and F3, tell me how well it matches. What percentage of the characters go together? And so, you know, like here, these ones that match only 9% or 0% or, you know, there's no match at all, you don't want to use those, but probably anything that has around 30% or more characters in common, those are the ones you want to go look at as possible matches. So this is, you know, something that's really tough. For Pat, someone had suggested some VBA, and, you know, she was supposed to go hire someone to write the VBA. That's the great thing about the message board. There's a lot of VBA already there, enough to at least help in solving this problem. There's no doubt about it. It's a very tough problem trying to match up data that might be in different columns, typed different ways, but using the fuzzy match logic, great way to go. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by, and we'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.